Charles Davidson. I'm the medical director of the Bluhm Cardiovascular Institute at Northwestern Medicine. So today we have a patient that's having symptoms from tricuspid valve regurgitation. He's having some edema, fatigue, shortness of breath, and our plan is to replace the tricuspid valve via transcatheter technique. This technology was in investigation for the last 5 years. We were really with it throughout it. We were thrilled when the FDA approved this recently, and now we are the first ones in the region to offer this to patients commercially. And this now allows us to treat patients via transcatheter therapy from a femoral vein and go in under echocardiographic and fluoroscopic guidance and replace the valve over the old existing valve. And it virtually eliminates tricuspid regurgitation. Procedure takes us about an hour to do. Today is our launch of the commercial availability of this to patients throughout the US. The benefits are they don't have to have open heart surgery. Their symptoms are clearly improved, and the studies have shown that. Patients are generally in the hospital for 1 to 2 days afterwards and then can go home and resume normal activities. What's exciting about it for us and for patients is this is transformational technology. So only a few times in your career where you really can do something that really changes patients' lives almost immediately, and it really has a high safety profile compared to the previous available treatments for this disease. We are on the forefront of the new technologies, and we try to offer those early to patients in a safe and very regulated way. We're looking to move the field forward, but to move the field forward in order to improve patients' lives and hopefully improve longevity. I would say with any new technology, it's important to look for centers that have a lot of experience in doing this, because there's a learning curve in applying these technologies. It's not just the interventional cardiologist that's doing this. We have cardiac surgery. We have our imaging team of echocardiographers, our anesthesia team. We have a whole valve team of nurses, coordinators, and nurse practitioners that help take care of these patients. It takes an army to really do this well. And that's why I think that certain centers will be able to offer this at a very high level. And that's what I'm hoping what patients will look for, and physicians that are referring patients in will look for their patients.